Let's see if I can do it, lore. What was I saying? There you go. These four.
I just wanted to know, what's your name?
Asuna?
No, not your screen name. Your real one.
Asuna. Asuna Yuki.
You used your real name? That's so weird.
It is? Wait, then what's your name?
Kazuto Kirigaya.
Ugh, no! That's a terrible name! What am I supposed to call you as a nickname? Kaz? I'm just gonna call you Kirito from now on.
I now present another one of the funniest goddamn moments in comics history. And while some of the words are changed, this actually happened.
Hey, Ken.
What's up?
Anyone ever tell you you look like Superman?
You know, actually, yeah, a ton of people tell me that. I personally don't see the resemblance, but apparently it's there. Oh, peekaboo, motherfucker!
Oh, Jesus Christ! Fuck?
Me and Mr. Mallet here are on vacation from Gotham, and I want to see how much chaos I can cause before the end of the day. So, eeny, miny, miny, this week. No, wait!
Fuck. God damn it, did this really have to happen on my shift? Shit. Okay, giant mallet. We've dealt with lasers and magic and bombs, but... God, how would a normal person react to getting hit with a giant mallet? Well, they'd probably fucking die, right? And of all people, Joker definitely knows how a normal person would react to this. Shit, should I just roll with it? Oh, fuck this, yeet.
Wait, how the fuck? No clue. Batman's right behind you, by the way.
Son of a...
Hey, man, having a nice vacation?
No.
Oh, come on, but did you see
Bruce? No.
Didn't you do that?
That is not the fucking point.
Can
you do that?
Why would I know how to chop a can in half with a card, Bruce? I don't fucking know, that's why it's cool!
So we're just recruiting Robins on the basis of cool now, huh? No, Dick, I let Damien bring home the bat cow for his karate skills. What the fuck do you think? Bruce?
Come on, he's got his own costume already and everything!
Bruce? No. Fine. Good. Thank you, Bruce.
Yeah, whatever. Don't mention it.
What are you doing?
Nothing, don't worry about it.
Who are you texting?
Nobody, fuck off!
You're texting Alfred, aren't you?
No, I'm not!
Yes, you are! Give me that phone!
Siri, text out!
Murder mystery, okay. But here's the twist. I'm the murderer. Let this be my victim. They caught on to me. They knew something was up, so I took them out. I took him out. No one will
know. Oh,
I'm fine. So I ditched the body and I think I'm good. I think I'm sneaky, but this person found out. Oh, she won. Now no one knows I'm the killer yet, but this person is starting to point some fingers.
He would.
So yeah, let's say Bob Joe blames me, which is great. Who defends me? From the grave? We're just not gonna look into that, but I blame this person. I put it on them.
He wrote it.
I put it on Teckly. He found the body. It's the perfect cover.
Yeah.
So I am this close to getting away scot-free, but then this person finds my murder weapon. Oh, I am! So the truth gets out. I make a run for it, but then this person takes me out.
Perfect finish.
He's been waiting for it too. Yeah.
So things look bad and your back's against the wall. Your whole existence seems fucking hopeless. You're feeling filthy.
We monsters, creeps and killers, but we'll miss you just the same. And don't be sad, we're stuck for eternity in constant torture, fire and pain. Cause there is love and joy and laughter. Who cares if it's wrong or right?
When I brought out the angel's head, couldn't help.
That fucker is back!
Yeah, I thought he was gone for good too.
It's been 7 years!
You still pissed? He almost beat you that time.
Fuck you!
Just saying.
Things have changed a lot since he left town.
That's for sure.
Cause
was when I brought out the angel's head. Couldn't help.
So here's a funny thing. So I found this laid back cam. I was like, oh good, this is fun. So I started watching episode 1 of 3 and I was like, this is weird. It feels like, oh wait, this is season 2. So yeah, that's why this has 4 and this is 12, because I watch episode 1, 2, and 3 of season 2, but that's not important because like I haven't finished this one, but like it's so like nice. It's just like a nice chill, a nice fun, relaxing sort of like time. I don't know why, it's just chill, it's relaxed. It's like stuff's happening. I don't need to worry. I don't know why, I just like that. It's fun, it's chill, it's just really nice. I don't know why. It's just talking about camping, and I love camping. I've been on camping before, I haven't done it in a while because I haven't had a reason or any sort of like stuff to do with, but it's fun, it's cool, and it's absolutely 100% worth it. And I love the idea where they like bring up camping ideas. They bring up like certain like things that you can do in camping, definitely with like the cooking the cooking area. Because like most of the time where I did camping, which was either with my family, which that's easier because if you're with your family, I was at that age where it's like, I think the last time I did it was like I was still in school. So it's like, your parents like, oh, I'll look after the cooking. Which now if I go camping again, I'll need to like cook by myself. And a couple of these things are like, oh, maybe I'll just shoot it. And like the other time was like DOV. But DOV is one of those things where it's like, with this, you're either like, they're either driving or like using like this. DOV, you have to like carry everything. And you're not going to carry a lot of stuff. I don't know if that's much for me. I just was like, here's sausages. We could just eat that with like some rice. And that's it. You more like try and like think about like, here's how you walk, here's how you do this. You don't bring complicated food, I don't think. At least for me. But yeah. This was fun. I don't even think I did rice. I think I did sausage and that's it. No, bread. I think it was like I did a sausage sandwich for like dinner. And for breakfast, I think I brought cereals. If anyone has like really good like camping meals, if I ever go back into camping, which I want to do, give it to me. Because I got like a single tent and that'd be fun. I want to do one of those things where I go on holiday. I know this is a tangent, but this is doing camping. So I feel like this is like fun and like interesting. I would do this thing where like you stop at one place, you move, like you like go to one place, you shop, you go over for a night, you move, you go over for another night, you camp. I mean, you do that for a bit. It's like what D&V is, and then like you go back to the center. That's what I feel like would be a fun idea to do. Maybe, I don't know. It just seems fun. So, yeah. Definitely gonna watch it. So, I watched this before the holiday, and I could have put this in the other view, but they felt a bit different. And I've watched up to here, but I feel like I've been hearing that there's 4 episodes in this. I'm going to give it, like, 1 more week. If I get nothing, I'm just going, because it's been, like, this has been watched, like, 3 weeks ago. I'm like, I don't have anything. But Crunchyroll is going to be put on pause because I want to go and watch, actually, no, I'm not going to put it on pause, but when I'm recording, I might be watching the Disney, X-Men thing. Because the new series is coming out and I haven't watched the original. Shocking, for sure, if I existed in 1997 and I was born in 1999, I did not watch it. So I'm gonna do that. But I am so, maybe when I'm like out and about, like watching this, I don't know. When I'm at my computer, where I'm gonna try and be more of a time, when my time's off, I'm gonna be watching that. Because I want to actually watch the new one because it looks so good. So I want to watch the old one. It's like, I think most of them have like only 13 episodes. And there's only 5 series. Which sounds like a lot, but in total it doesn't. Because like the first 2 series have like 26. Which I think a lot more series. And it does get more. I think season 2 and season season 3 and 4 have, like, 20, so it will be a bit. Also, Captain America's in the one, which is, like, funny. That's besides the point. I'm getting ahead of myself. This movie, I don't know why I kept talking about that, but anyway, this movie I think is, like, really good, because I like the idea that, one, we could never come back to any of these characters, but I love the idea that you bring in this story, you bring in this character, you bring in a reason why, like, oh, why weren't they here from this moment forward, etc., etc., etc. Like, why on earth didn't they do this, or that, or the other? And it's like, oh yeah, you could have been there, but it's like, there's a reason. I understand that. It makes sense. It's, like, really interesting. I love the characters. I love the problem isn't in a way, like, the problem isn't, like, and all it is here's the bad guy. The problem, there is, like, a bad guy, but I love the initial thing where it's, like, who's lying? It's basically, like, one person saying one thing and one person saying another. And I love the conflicts, basically. So, you doubted your brother and you didn't think of, like, you know, talking to him. You need to be straightforward. You need to be like, is it weird that they're like, because, like, they could have pointed something out, and maybe they did. Maybe they did, but I just love that they didn't talk to each other. And that's the whole crux of the problem. Communication. I find that funny. Anyway. So, yeah, this is fun. It's so good, and I absolutely recommend to go and watch this.
I will do all the single ladies.
Phrasing. Just wanted to do this. My bestie is Katana. This is just weird. So yeah.
We monsters, creeps, and killers, but we'll miss you just the same. And don't be sad, we're stuck for eternity in constant torture, fire, and pain. Cause there is love and joy and laughter. Who cares if it's wrong or right?
Quickest ever ASMR, let's go!
I don't know why I like ASMR, because, no, I don't listen to it, but I like the sort of, like, when you have, like, a quiet voice. Let's see. I don't know why I just love these weird things, because they exist, and why not? And I'm never going there, so I'm fine. Let's see. I think. What's wrong with my eye? It's blue, but I feel like it's like that? I don't know. Is it like a little bit more lighter? If it's a little bit more lighter. A bit rare. I know blue eyes isn't a thing, and I know I like blue eyes is not, it is a thing, I have blue eyes. But I know it's more rarer than most. So yeah. I like this one. I'm not watching this one. I'm trying to catch up with the old version first before.
Hey there. I'm in your phone. Let me out!
Hey, my body.
While adorable.
Is the least interesting thing about me.
Your body. Also adorable.
Is the least interesting thing about you.
The best parts of you and me are always here.
Good days, bad days, big pants, small pants. Still me.
Stop waiting on your body to start living your life.
Get out there and give them the old razzle fucking dazzle. You got one life and there's two rules. Don't be a shitty person. Try to have some fun. Keep it up, cutie. I'm so proud of you.
Blue box in the alley. Is it a TARDIS?
Might be. What's it to you?
It could be worth a lot.
Nah, not that one. Second hand. Huge mileage. One careless owner. Mind you, it's better than a vortex manipulator. Like the one on your wrist. Cheap and nasty time travel.
Unlikely lines from a children's book.
I will never tell you my name. You will have to guess my name, said Rumpelstiltskin. Really holding up the queue at Starbucks.
So, I watched this Mars Red, and it's sort of like, I like it. It runs on the line of like, dark yet fun. It's like nice, it's interesting, with like, really like, interesting ideas. I just love the show. The show is just really fun. It's weird. It's so good. And I love how they depict vampires as like, there's a ranking system. And it's so good. And there was one point where I thought, oh, we're going to go in this sort of like idea with this thing. And then it was like, vroom. And it was like, oh, I did not see that coming. I think it was like so good and like really creative. And it was just fun, amazing. It is worth watching, and it is absolutely just amazing, and it's absolutely just awesome. So I definitely 100% recommend to watch this.
Chocolate mayonnaise cake from 56. This has been my most requested cake. Of course, it's the mayonnaise. Flour. Sugar.
Floofers.
Today you will rise.
Powdered cocoa.
Why she smells like chocolate.
Mayonnaise.
And it's not just a little bit.
No, no, it's a severe, unauthorized cup of mayonnaise.
Cup of water.
Honey, you can't dilute a war crime. You know, it's horrible now, but I hope it turns out okay. Like children. I'm sending you to summer camp.
For the frosting, we boil milk, sugar, cocoa, and margarine.
Fire!
Beat in mayonnaise to the chocolate.
Do you keep it in your purse?
Hello.
Maybe if I just don't think about it.
Good heavens. Holy fuck.
Fantastically moist. The chocolate is tangy. I'll concede you were right.
Let's see what I get. My love card devices. Sometimes loving. Oh, yeah. That is fitting.
Unlikely lines from a children's book.
Tales of the Unexpected. Once upon a...
Also, a bit of an update. On the long form, the longer one that's going to come out tomorrow, explains a bit more. But I said something about, like, overdrive might get the recordings down to 5. Because I didn't fell through, that's not gonna happen. That's why it's like you've been seeing, like, besides the blank week, it's gone back to normal. Besides, well, more less than normal than it did before, that was 15. But that was just a cover. It's gonna be the same, well, 10 on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Friday, Saturday. And then, I'm going to stop for Sundays. You'll get still the long recording, etc., etc., all of that will happen. But, you know, less.
Unlikely things to hear on Comic Relief.
Of course, we're also supporting projects in the UK. For example, this is my extension.
How could you?
How could I what?
You said we would destroy the Avengers, make a better world.
It will be better.
When everyone is dead.
That is not the human race, Renette. every opportunity to improve.
And if they don't?
Ask Noah.
You're a madman.
Please, don't do this.
What choice do we have?
Oh, great! We have no leads, the Turks have a head start, and Red's too stoned to guide us! Please, universe, give us more headaches! Surprise attack! Fools! Now you face the great ninja, you... Now that's a surprise attack!
Let's see. I think these two. And then go this one. Then go like this. Nope. Is it cake free? This, I just love this season. Because how they did the first bit and how they kept like doing fun sections. Like the one thing which I like is they actually had in one of the sections a sort of team up in it, which I'm like, ooh, that's fun. I love the idea. It's so cool. And overall just so just absolutely chaotic fun. Is it cook just says it itself. It's like just picking up my and being like, can I eat this? And that's how it feels like, essentially. It's basically like just getting an item and be like, is this cake or is this cake? And that's what you expect. Insane fun. There's not much that you need to describe with this show because that's as simple as it gets. Is it cake? It's that mad. It's just, is this item a cake? Oh. And that's it. You don't need more. It's insane fun. Watch it. You can watch all three seasons. So yeah, go watch it.
Back in black, baby.
And yes, I do have a rainbow of them.
I mean, why not? We're back at it again with the night shift memes. Let's go.
The road to hell. Carlsbad Caverns National Park, New Mexico.
Whoa.
That shit is wild, fam. Boy, I hope there's a fucking exit on the other side because I ain't walking my ass back up. Fuck that. I live here now. At least hell is wheelchair accessible. That's terrible. Oh my God. Imagine somebody accidentally lets a stroller go down that thing. You probably feel bad for laughing, but all I'm thinking is, hey, man, they better know how to drift. Okay, you're screwed. But are you holstered tactical pans screwed? What the fuck?
Get on the ground! Stop resisting!
Think outside the box.
What in the fuck? That's not how you... What?
Hold on a second, forget the motto. The sheer level of fucking savagery in this picture, let me explain. Not only did they prevent the O's victory up top here, but this motherfucker said, yeah, I could beat you here, but since you're trash, I'll beat you wherever the fuck I want. Beach. Me with my girlfriend. Don't feel jealous.
Your girlfriend got some strange knees, my dude. Looking like a confused flamingo.
And the feet made him look like chimpanzee paws.
It's about time you fell in love with something that will love you back. And that, my friends, is house music. It doesn't judge you, and I won't either.
Mr. Vice President. Mr. Madison. Senator Burr. What is this?
Go down and exterminate demon ass.
Destroy that ass.
Prepare to slaughter every sinner in that shit hotel. And you all remember Vaggie.
Rip Vaggie's cut mouth out her ass.
You just chill, loot. Fuck.
What? A villain. Every good story needs a villain. You honestly think that you're the hero in all of this? Well, of course I am. Who else could I possibly be?
Wait to come down and exterminate you.
gonna go down and exterminate demon ass.
Destroy that ass.
Prepare to slaughter every sinner in that shit hotel. And you all remember Vaggie.
Boo! Rip Vaggie's cut mouth out her ass.
You just chill, Loot.
Let's just try. 3, 2, 1. Okay, so, okay, I didn't know that was having to be added. I don't know why. Because sometimes if you switch to specific settings, I don't know why. That's besides the point. Here's this. It's okay. It's fun. I haven't seen this series. I've watched Loud House, at least part of the first, like, season. And I haven't really watched beyond that because, like, one, I thought it was just okay, the original season one of it, and then I heard very weird things about it. I'm like, I'm gonna put that down and just leave that forever. And then it's like season two, which I've heard bad things, but you know, this was on Netflix, and I heard like, magic gods. I'm like, So I was like, I'm gonna watch this, and it was like, oh, you gotta watch the series? No. Nope. I've heard it's bad, so I'm not. But I heard this was weird. So there's, because I know that was two birds talking. Is that like a normal thing in the series? I don't know. I don't know if magic is a normal occurrence in the series. It could be. It could very well be. But yeah, this is it. I don't know. Watch it, don't. It's just decent, fine, nothing great, nothing bad, just watch it.
How did you get, we voted you off, if you don't practice previous episode of this, you were voted off with Ben saying no more imposters. Ah! He's trying to get me, no!
Let's see, night. Winter, because I like that. Sweets, obviously. Cook, you know, like cooking. Sleep, who's like sleep? Be mountain, I mean. Stay at home. Cold showers. Most of the time, I know it's like dogs. I don't know, I'm just like airbending, whoosh. So yeah, this is what I got. Now, let's see the SpongeBob murder mystery. Who is the victim? Let's get the detective on the scenes. I love it. I love these characters. I don't know. We have the dirty bubble. The dirty bubble is going to question the person who found the body. Ah, yes, you. Who? Let's look at the cameras and let's see who was last seen with Mrs. Puff. It was me. I forgot. It was the dirty bubble himself. He forgot that. Let's think about who we think did it. King Neptune did it. But who does dirty bubble arrest? Well, no one then, because she's dead. Ah, it's Plankton. We should have pulled that through. But yeah. Let's see what I get. I am yay. And okay. I don't know why I do these. I just find these fun. So here's another one of these fun filters. I don't know why I'm doing this, it's just, I feel like this would be like fun, so I'm doing it anyway. As a person who also isn't bad at English, which always says I'm dyslexic as an excuse, I can't say TH correctly. If you look at my lips, if I say the, this, you can see, I don't know if that matters, because most of the time when I say the, a tree is over there, you don't really take fee. And but if you say va and then I say fee, va fee, va fee, you can see both lips. If you, I don't know if that's important, but the one that I always get is Pacific. And if you don't know why, what I meant by that, if you're thinking, what, that's the exact same word that I meant when you're talking about the Pacific, the, like, the Pacific Ocean. No, I wasn't. This is a, I'm talking about this Pacific pen. Pacific. I know that's not how you pronounce that, like when you're saying this Pacific item. I know, I just don't care. I think there's like one more that I'm not good at or like great at. I don't, but like that's the one that like Pacific. That's just a funny one. So there you go. Is it ever gonna change? Am I gonna feel this way forever? Are you gonna be around for me to count on? Is it ever gonna change? Am I gonna feel this way? So here's the thing. I've been watching The Apprentice. I haven't said this, but I have reviewed previous seasons, so. So this is a spoiler for episode 11 and only this episode. Actually, for like, for anything before and during episode 11, so not the finale because, you know, it not being out yet. But I have watched this. And you have this person, who I kind of had a feeling would be in the finale because, even though he is charming, and I actually wanted him to win, he sort of had a, like, I think he only won, like, 4 times, compared to, like, both the women winning, I think, 9 times. But if you look at the interview stage, you can see why this plan here, the plan, not the person, wasn't the greatest. And same here, his plan fell through, and then he kind of went to a secondary plan, but didn't give a 50-50. But, like, his sort of thing, whereas, like, he switched into deep, was very smart. But I definitely thought this person was going to win. But in my opinion, I thought it was going to be, when they got rid of this person and then this person, in my opinion, then you have 1, 2, and 3. In my opinion, I thought these two were going to be the finalists. Because you've lost 9 times. 9 in a row. Let's just point this out. 1, 2, 3, 4... 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All of his challenges, he lost. And then when he was put as PM, he had his one and only win. So, how he's still here, I don't know. That's my question. Could he win this when he lost 9 times? Technically, you could say that this is meaning he won twice because he went through to the interview stage. Because at the interview stage and at the interview stage, you don't really have like two sides of like a team that wins and a team that loses. You just pass or fail. So you kind of can see this as a second win for him because he went to the final five, which fair. But if you just take the competition where you have like one side versus the other side, he lost all of these, and this one, he lost all of these. How did not one of these people bring up that he's lost 9 times? Not one of them. I heard say, oh, by the way, he's lost 9 times. That's why you shouldn't be his business partner. How is he still here? This is a miracle. Yeah, sorry for ranting, I just had to say that, because, like, how? There was one person, I think, like, last year, who also had, no, not last year, I think it was, like, 20, it was, like, 2 years ago, like, I think it was, like, before the pandemic, I think it was, like, 2019 the year, where he, like, he lost 8 times, and then got fired after that. But he's lost 9 times, 9 times in a row. This is a record. But, yeah.
Why? I hate you. You are mutating the wrong things. And why did I get cold? I am actively going at them.
So I watched this, and I've seen, and if I'm correct, I think I have. I'm not 100% sure. I'm pretty sure, but I'm not gonna like be like, and then here's I've watched the other one. So I'm not gonna review this on Spider-Man No Way Home. So it's not me reviewing Spider-Man No Way Home, because I've done it and I liked it. And I still like it. A lot of people are like, oh, well, it's not as good nowadays. Like, if you look back on it, it's like, nope, it's still awesome. Nostalgia should be damned, I don't care. Yeah, I watched both series. I think I watched the Amazing Spider-Man, and then I watched the original series, because you have three sets of series, which I think is called either Spider-Man, the Amazing Spider-Man, and I think Spider-Man Marvel, I think that's what it's called, and that, if not, that's what I call them. Also, if you're asking which is my favorite sort of like series so far, I'm a big fan of The Amazing Spider-Man, because I'm a big fan of like Andrew Garfield and like his sort of like more sarcastic wit to him. And I just like that, like, I don't know why, when he does his like wit, I love it. I do understand the criticism, I just like that a bit more. And I did watch the original, and I do love it still. And all that being said, I do love Spider-Man and all three of them. I'm a big fan of all three. I do get why people are like, oh, the first sort of like two Spider-Mans aren't really a Spider-Man, because he doesn't have the story of like sacrifice and it like has to be a thing. I do get it. I still do like it. That doesn't affect me too much. And I wasn't a bit too affected before this came out, where it's like, oh, there's no Uncle Ben scene. The same thing where it's like, I think someone made a TikTok, I forgot who, it was like ages ago, where one of the things was like, oh no, they created a new Superman series, but they're not gonna have the origins of Superman. Like, we don't need it. You could just, like, if they're making, like, I think, I don't know if they're making movie or series, you could just, like, have one episode, flashback. Like, you don't need it, in my opinion. Like, I think a lot of people, like, said there's, like, a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde BBC series. I haven't watched it. I'm not really planning to. But it's like, episode one, you kind of get into like, this exists. You don't have his it being started. Here's the introduction. Let's go. Because sometimes you don't. If you get it, you get it. If you want to lay more, that's what flashbacks are for. So you don't need to be like, and then let's start from the very beginning. Like, I'm getting that. It's the same with, like, I'm watching X-Men currently, every, in between, like, recording these. And, like, we don't need the scene where it's like, okay, let's start and form the team at the very beginning, because it's fine. Like, saying there's already a team, it already exists. So, sorry on the rambling about the past. This is just my opinion and what I'm saying with it. Anyway, when I watched the original, I loved it. I get it. I do know it. And I do admit that I think, like, a couple other people, not because I read it, was a bit hesitant, because based on what this was supposedly being based on, which is the comic, which supposedly is, like, really hated and really not liked. So I was like, okay, this is apparently bad. That's where my angle came from. So I loved it. I loved the cameos. I love all of this fun, like, oh, it's this. I like it. It's just fun and just nice. And what about the new stuff? It's okay. I already loved this. It doesn't take away. It's still a good sort of movie. You still have that good experience. Is what is added needed? No. There's a couple of nice interactions. There's a couple of nice scenes. I'm not going to say it's bad. But I don't know why you make a second version of a already, like, Spider-Man No Way Home, extended version. Okay, you just added a few scenes of, like, nice interaction. And fair. It is fair. Like, I think one of the scenes is, like, the three Spider-Man talking together about, like, a couple of, like, Spider-Man problems. I'm like, sure. It's okay. It's still good. Both versions. I also watch this because, like, they're nice. But if it's, like, this is going to be taken down, you're never going to see it, I'm going to be like, okay, the original version exists, I'm fine with that. So, it's good. I don't know why it's needed, but it's still good. So yeah, this is a weird review video because I've never done something like this. I don't even think I've reviewed, because I haven't. I don't think I have watched it. I haven't reviewed the DC extended version of Batman vs. I think I did watch it at some point. I don't know. Maybe. No, I think I did. I just haven't reviewed it. Because I'm like, oh, I've already watched it. But that's besides the point. I might do that, or I might, I don't know. But here's a weird review. I don't know.